Hi. In this course, we are going to look at integrals and we are going to figure out how to solve definite and indefinite integrals. And we'll do a lot of questions which will be relevant for your JE mains and advanced. And hopefully you will learn a lot through this course. What we want to do is basically look at these particular chapters, indefinite and definite integration, in a lot of detail. Like, there is a lot of techniques to solve questions in these chapters, and students sometimes struggle with this. So what I want to do is a problem solving course here. We will learn every technique through solving relevant problems. So I have handpicked these questions, and hopefully we'll cover enough to help you tackle JE advanced problems and even beyond. So let's get started. We'll start off with the first question. This is integral of x square minus 1 divided by x power 4 plus 1 and x plus 1 dx. Right. So this integral that we want to look at, ideally, I would want to split this fraction in some way. If I can split this fraction, then my job will be easier. Okay, I have made a mistake here in writing it. It is x cube minus 1 on top. X cube minus 1. So notice that right now I cannot factorize, and that doesn't help me because no factors are matching, right? I will get an x minus 1 factor here, but I am getting x plus 1 here, right? And this is not factorizable. So immediately you cannot think of anything, but let's try to get an x plus one common somehow, right? If we try to get an x plus one common, how do you get that? So what I will do is I will add and subtract an x power 4 on top, right? Notice that if you do this, right? If you do this, you can split it into two parts. One part will be x power 4 plus x power 3. And one part will be minus x power 4 plus 1, right? So that helps us a lot, because x power 4 plus x power 3 by x power 4 plus 1 into x plus 1 minus x power 4 plus 1 by x power 4 plus 1 into x plus 1. This is a much easier integral, because in this one, this factor gets cancelled, and here we can take x cube common and x plus 1 will get cancelled. So I will split it into two separate integrals, x cube x plus 1 by x power 4 plus 1 minus 1 by x plus 1, right? So this x power 4 plus 1 into x plus 1 was there, and this got cancelled. So you have integral of x cube by dx by x power 4 plus 1 minus ln x plus 1. This is the integration of 1 by x, right? You take x plus 1 as t, and you will get 1 by t dt, which is integral is ln t, right? So, and this part also, you can take x power 4 plus 1 as t, and you will get 4 x cube dx. So x power 4 plus 1 is t, you will get 4 x cube dx as your dt, right? And your x cube dx is therefore dt by 4. So the integral becomes dt by 4 t. So you have 1 by 4 ln x power 4 plus 1 minus ln x plus 1. This will be your answer, right? So notice that as we go along this course, we'll look at many techniques to solve integrals. What I want you to do is focus on how we are thinking about it. And before you look at the solution, just pause the video and try to do it yourself. Like, unless you try doing these integrals, these methods will not stick in your memory. You don't want to just learn it and then forget it 2 months later, right? So attempt the questions first, then look at the solutions. And notice how I'm thinking about it. I just wanted to split the fraction here. Like, I don't care because right now there is no way to integrate this. If I separate it into different fractions, I will have a way. So I think thought of adding x power 4 because I wanted a minus x power 4 minus 1 so that I can take this x power 4 plus 1 cancels, right? And it eventually worked out. The question was designed in such a way that as soon as you split the fraction, you will be able to solve it, right? So we will learn all our techniques through solving problems. So that is the idea behind the course. So let's move on. We have question number 2, which is, if g of x is equal to 4 cos power 4x minus 2 cos 2x minus half cos 4x minus x power 7 to the power 1 by 7. Then you have to find out integral of g of x dx. Now basically, it's a composition of g with itself, right? So it will be nice if I can simplify this expression into something nice, right? Because doing a composition here will be really annoying. So we have no choice. We cannot find g of x directly here, right? So the only way we can do that, if we can simplify g of x a lot, right? So let's think of how to simplify this part. So 4 cos power 4x minus, let's reduce all the higher powers of cos, minus 2 into this is 2 cos square x minus 1 minus half into cos 4x is 2 cos square 2x minus 1 minus x power 7. And let's worry about this part here. So this becomes 4 cos power 4x minus 4 cos square x plus 2 minus cos square 2x plus half minus x power 7, right? So again, simplifying this part, you get 4 cos power 4x minus 4 cos square x plus 2 minus, this is 2 cos square x minus 1 whole square plus half minus x power 7. So this becomes minus 4 cos power 4x plus 1, so becomes minus 1, and minus 4 cos square x becomes plus 4 cos square x. And there is a plus 2 here, and 4 cos power 4x minus 4 cos square x minus x power 7, right? So notice that this cancels this cancels this, and you are left with, there's a plus half also. So you're left with 3 by 2, 2 minus 1 plus half, 3 by 2 minus x power 7, right? This is your function g, right? So this is my function, and I will just write the function g here. G of x is equal to 3 by 2 minus x power 7 to the power 1 by 7, right? You will realize that g will be the inverse of itself. So these types of functions generally are inverses of each other. We'll see what happens here. We have to find out g of x, right? So g of x, let's do on the next screen. G of x is equal to 3 by 2 minus x power 7 to the power 1 by 7. g of x will be 3 by 2 minus, inside, instead of x, I will put 3 by 2 minus x power 7 to the power 1 by 7. And this has to be raised to the power 7, right? And whole thing is to the power 1 by 7. What am I doing? Instead of x, I am replacing the whole function, right? So this was the function g. So gx power 7 and then whole power 1 by 7. Now notice that 1 by 7 and 7 will cancel, and you'll get 3 by 2 minus 3 by 2 plus x power 7 whole to the power 1 by 7. So this cancels, and this is x, right? X power 7 into this. So what you're getting is g of x is equal to x, which means that g was the inverse of g. So the function is its own inverse, right? So that's fine. And we got this thing. And now we just have to evaluate what? We have to evaluate integral of g of x, right? And that will be just integral of x dx. So that will be x squared by 2 plus c. Right? So the question is solved once you can figure out your g function, which was a basic simplification of trigonometric ratios. So that should not be a big deal for most of you. So just simplify stuff. Don't immediately start putting g of g, right? Let's look at question number 3. This is integral x squared minus x plus 1 divided by x squared plus 1 multiplied by e cot inverse x dx is equal to a of x multiplied by cot inverse e power cot inverse x, e power cot inverse x plus c. Now, what you have to find is a of x. A of x is equal to what? So there are actually two ways to do this. One way to do it is to differentiate this expression. If you differentiate this expression, this side becomes simply x squared minus x plus 1, because integral and differentiation are opposite operations. So a d by dx here will cancel the integration sign. So you'll just be left with this part. And that will be equal to here, you have to differentiate this. So that will be a dash x e cot inverse x plus a of x e cot inverse x multiplied by the derivative of cot inverse, which is equal to minus 1 by 1 plus x squared. And that's it. So now we have to basically understand that you have x squared plus 1 a dash x minus a of x by x squared plus 1 multiplied by e cot inverse x is equal to this thing, x squared minus x plus 1 by x squared plus 1 e cot inverse x. Right? So we have to match this. This has to be same. So obviously you can see that here you can write x squared plus 1 minus x is equal to x squared plus 1 a dash x minus ax. Right? So if you see this, you can easily guess that a of x is equal to x, and that will make a dash x is equal to 1, and that will satisfy this equation, right? You will find a of x very easily by differentiating. However, if you did not think of differentiation, what will we do? We can integrate this expression directly and then see what happens, right? How do you integrate such expressions? So whenever you have this type of a situation where there is an e power x and there is something in a bracket after that, right? You should remember that it could be of the form e power fx, f of x plus f dash x. So what I mean to say is you could have a situation where e power x, f of x plus f dash x dx. This integral is a very standard integral, and the answer is e power x f of x here plus c. How do we get that? We can do it by parts. So if you do e power x f of x dx plus e power x f dash x dx, right? This is my integral. Let's do integration by parts here. So I will take this as the second function, this as the first function. So you'll get f of x integral of e power x minus differentiation of e power x. Which one did I take as the first function? First function was, let's take this as the first function. I made a mistake, I think. This is the first function and this is the second function. Then when you integrate it, you will keep fx as it is, integrate e power x, which is e power x, minus, you will now differentiate f dash x and answer of this integral, so e power x. So notice that this cancels the second one, right? So the answer, this integral actually cancels out the second part of the first integral. The answer is this, right? Notice here that it is e power something else, and there is something else here, right? So if we can get it into this form, then it will work out very easily because we know the answer of this integral, right? So generally try to look at this form and try to approach questions where e power x is there and there is another factor by thinking of maybe we can reduce it to this particular form, right? So in order to do that reduction, what you will need to do is I need one variable here, not a function here, right? So what I will do is cot inverse x, I will put as t. So therefore x will be equal to cot t, right? And that will mean that dx is equal to minus cosec square t dt, right? And now I have integral becomes x is cot t. So cot square t minus cot t plus 1 divided by cot square t plus 1, right? And here you have e power t, and x is dx is minus cosec square t dt. Now 1 plus cot square t will be actually cosec square t, I think. Yes, it will be cosec square t. So that cancels out this term. And what we get is 1 plus cot square t on top, this and this, cosec square t minus cot t into e power t dt, right? Now notice that you have e power something and you have f of x and f dash x here. Like, which is my f of x? My f of x is this minus of cot t, and f dash x is this. So f t is minus cot t, then f dash t will be plus cosec square t, right? This is basic standard derivatives. And you will get a situation where you have f t plus f dash t multiplied by e power t, right? Dt. So the answer of this integral should be e power t f of t, right? So my integral becomes e power cot inverse x. E power t is e power cot inverse x multiplied by f of t. F of t is minus cot t, right? Minus cot t is minus x, right? Minus x e power cot inverse x, right? That is coming out as my integral, right? So again, ax cot inverse x, ax is equal to x again is coming from here, right? So that is something that you can do. Let's move on. Let's look at the next question. So here, keep in mind here that we have learned this integral, e power t f of t plus f dash t integral is equal to e power t f of t. This is a very standard thing. The way to prove this is by parts. You split the original integral into two parts and solve the first integral by parts, right? Okay. Let's move on to question number 4. And here we have, let f be a polynomial function such that for all real x, f of x square plus 1 is equal to x power 4 plus 5x square plus 2. Then what is the integral of f of x dx, right? So before you can find the integral, what you have to do is find out what is f of x, right? So can we deduce what is f of x from this part, right? So that is possible because here, instead of x, we have x squared plus 1. So if we are able to write this part in terms of x squared plus 1, our job will be done, right? So let's think about it. F of x squared plus 1 is equal to, this part I can write as x squared plus 1 whole square, which will mean which terms? Which will mean x power 4 plus 2x squared plus 1. So now what is left for us? There is 3x square plus 1 that is left, right? So again, I want to use x square plus 1. So I'll write x square plus 1 whole square plus 3x square plus 3 minus 2, right? So this will become x square plus 1 whole square plus 3 times x square plus 1 minus 2. So that is your f of x square plus 1. So that implies simply that f of x must be x square plus 3x minus 2, right? If f of x was this, f of x square plus 1 would be this expression. And this expression is actually what is there in the problem. So finding the integral here is really easy now. Integral of fx dx will simply be x cubed by 3 plus 3 by 2 x square minus 2x plus c, right? The whole question was being able to figure out f of x from this part, right? Okay, let's move on. Question number 5. Here we will look at the integral of secant square theta multiplied by sec theta plus tan theta whole square d theta. Okay. So how do we approach this? Now here we should try to use the identity sec square theta minus tan square theta is equal to 1. So that identity helps you realize that sec theta minus tan theta multiplied by sec theta plus tan theta is equal to 1, right? So if I take this whole thing as some variable, if sec theta plus tan theta is equal to y, right? You realize from here that sec theta minus tan theta is equal to 1 by y, right? Because sec theta minus tan theta is 1 by sec theta plus tan theta. And therefore, 2 sec theta is equal to y plus 1 by y by adding, right? So therefore, what we get is sec theta is coming out to be half of y plus 1 by y, correct? Now, what is my, if you take this as a change of variable, what is your dy? Dy is equal to sec theta differentiation is sec theta tan theta plus secant square theta, and the whole thing is d theta. So you can say that this is sec theta common tan theta plus sec theta d theta, right? This is your dy, right? So here I can split this integral like this, sec theta into sec theta plus tan theta multiplied by sec theta into sec theta plus tan theta d theta, right? So if I take sec theta plus tan theta as y, this whole part becomes my dy, right? And sec theta becomes what? Half of y plus 1 by y. So you get half of y plus 1 by y multiplied by dy, right? So now this integral is really easy. It is just y square by 2, integral of y square by 2 plus 1 by 2, right? Dy. So the answer becomes y cube by 3 into 2 plus y by 2 plus c. So this is equal to y cube by 6 plus y by 2 plus c. And now you put back your y. Y is sec theta plus tan theta. So that will come as my answer. So the question was really simple. If you think of taking this as your t, and since there are two powers here, the powers can be split and you can have sec theta plus tan theta one side and another sec theta plus tan theta to take care of the dy. So right now, so far, all the problems that we are seeing, we are mostly using the method of change of variable. We are using method of substitution. And that is the most powerful method that you should think of first. So as we go and discuss more and more methods of solving problems, we will come up with a strategy that helps us decide what to think of first when looking at an unknown integral, right? There is a way to approach it, and that is what we learn by solving these questions. So let's look at this one. E power x, 2 tan x by 1 plus tan x, plus cot square x plus pi by 4 dx, right? What is this equal to? Okay, so in this particular question, notice that it looks like this, e power x fx. It looks not immediately, you don't know what is fx, but it looks in this form, right? we know the answer to this is e power x f of x. So we have to figure out what is the f of x and what is the f dash x, right? Okay. Cot square is here. I don't want a cot here, so I'll convert to a tan square. And if I have to convert cot to tan, I should do pi by 2 minus this theta, right? Pi by 2 minus x plus pi by 4, right? I need a tan square because everything else is in tans. So I'll just write it like this. And this will become tan square of pi by 4 minus x. Pi by 4 minus x. And this is 2 tan x by 1 plus tan x. Correct? Okay. You have tan square here. So correct. So we have to think of what function will give us fx plus f dash x here, right? So here, if you differentiate this, it might be complicated. Sec square x, it might be complicated here. So what I will do is I'll convert this to, if there is a tan, there should be a secant square something, right? So this is secant square pi by 4 minus x minus 1. Why? Because tan's derivative is secant square, right? So I need a secant square here if I have to differentiate some tan function. So I'll just write it like this, 2 tan x by 1 plus tan x plus secant square x minus 1. And this minus 1 can be combined with this one, right? So if you do 2 tan x minus 1, 2 tan x by 1 plus tan x minus 1. Tan x by 1 plus tan x minus 1. It will be equal to 2 tan x minus 1 minus tan x. So it will be tan x minus 1 by tan x plus 1, right? So this thing can be thought of as tan x minus tan pi by 4 by 1 plus tan x into tan pi by 4, because tan pi by 4 is equal to 1. So this is basically tan of x minus pi by 4, right? The reason I thought of this is because there is a pi by 4 minus x here, right? So we can write this now as tan of x minus pi by 4 plus secant square x minus pi by 4, because secant square pi by 4 minus x is the same thing as secant square x minus pi by 4. So an outside there was an e power x, right? And notice that now if you take f of x as this, this is your f dash x, right? So the answer should be e power x into tan of x minus pi by 4, correct? This should be your answer to this integral. Using the formula for the integral, e power x into is multiplied by fx plus f dash x, right? So that was the trick here, like writing the tan cot square as the tan square and tan square as the sec square. And after that, combining this minus one with this part and then noticing that it is also coming tan of x minus pi by 4, right? Okay, let's look at one more problem for this particular video. This is integral of ln x multiplied by ln x multiplied by ln x ln x plus 1 plus ln x whole divided by ln x multiplied by ln of x ln x dx. This is my integral. Looks very complicated, but we'll try to think of what we can do to solve this, right? Okay. Okay. So first of all, notice that there are two terms in the numerator, this term plus this term, actually three terms, but we can combine these two together. So why don't we split this fraction into two separate fractions? Because if you do two separate fractions, you will cancel this, this will cancel this, this, You'll get what? You'll get ln of x ln x ln x dx plus integral 1 plus ln x by ln x into ln of x ln x dx, right? This is what you get. Now, this is the integral. Correct. Okay. If we try to do this one, what we can think of is, let's try integration by parts here. Call it the first function and one is the second function. So I will say this is equal to ln of x ln x ln x multiplied by x minus x is the integral of one minus differentiation of this. So this is x by x ln x multiplied by differentiation of this part. This part differentiation will be ln of x ln x plus x times differentiation of that will be by x ln x multiplied by differentiation of x ln x will be ln x plus x by x. This is a very complicated differentiation because there are so many functions. So what I'm doing is basically integrating by parts. And while doing that, I took this as the first function, one as the second function. So this term is fine. And then I have to write the answer of this integral x here and then differentiate this thing, right? You should pause and try to differentiate this. First, I have differentiated by taking one by this, which is this term. Then I have to differentiate the inside part. For the inside part, I did first differentiation of x, which is one into this, plus x into differentiation of this part, which is one by x ln x multiplied by differentiation of the last bracket, which is ln x plus x by x, right? So this is one. And we have this cancels. And we have ln x, this term will cancel. So this will be one plus, this will cancel. And we get one by ln x multiplied by ln of x ln x. And on top we have one plus ln x, right? This is the integral, right? And notice, this is the integral that is coming. It's a negative sign. And you have x ln x ln x ln x here. Now, this is the first integrals by parts, right? Notice that this can be split into two integrals. And this will be x ln x ln x ln x minus integral of one, which is minus x, minus this part's integral. And see what is the second integral. The second integral immediately cancels this, right? So that cancels and your answer is this expression. Your answer should be x ln your answer should be this expression because everything else is getting cancelled. Like if you're unsure here, just go through the steps. What are we doing? We are dividing this whole thing into two separate fractions. Once you do two separate fractions, we are getting one integral here and another integral here, right? What we will do is we will solve this first integral by parts. And in that, the answer comes in such a way that the second integral gets cancelled. So we don't need to do the second integral at all, right? So that is the idea. It's a slightly tricky one because of the multiple log functions present, but we get the answer eventually, right? Okay, so that was the first video. We'll continue discussing more and more problems, and we'll see a lot more techniques and tricks to solve integrals, and we'll go on to definite integrals also eventually. But stay tuned, you will learn a lot from this lecture, and hopefully this should prepare you for JEE Advanced very well for the integral calculus portion. So see you in the next video.